Nabanja expressed concern that some parents and guardians have a tendency of delaying sending children to school, hence affecting their concentration and performance.
The purpose is to have our children go back to school, all of them. And also we talked about income-generating activities. We are looking at parish involvement model and also encouraging our people to join the parish circle and to see that our children go back to school, and they should start on time tomorrow.
The Kamsenene village chairman, Radson Chesanga, says they will carry out operations in the villages to ensure that children return to school.
Kando butasoma buletirwa abazaire abakazi bayebekambira abana babo kubawererera.
Nabanja says that members of parliament have been sent on recess to see the oversight of the parish development model program, and she promised to avail the necessary guidelines to ensure that they monitor the progress.
As of parliament are in recess, and this was an agreement between the speaker and the president, and of course we the ministers are also going to follow suit. We are going to give them guidelines so that they can know, one, what they expect from the the parish to have got. Of course we have sent money in all parishes in the country, but we are wondering whether this money has trickled down to the people.
Relatedly, down Kampala was a beehive of activity today as parents flooded the streets and shopping centers to do last-minute back-to-school shopping. The vendors have displayed their merchandise on the streets to serve their customers. As schools across the country are set to reopen tomorrow, parents were seen in a last-minute rush to purchase school items for their children. However, they have decried the high cost of scholastic materials.
The situation is in the
Parents were also seen escorting learners to school. Most of the parents were seen purchasing rims, books, among other scholastic materials. At the tax park, business was as usual, as drivers decried the low number of passengers.
I've been in taxi business for a long time, but I've never seen such a situation where we can hardly fill a taxi. Students used to book our vans, but this isn't happening anymore. People don't really have money, and that's the fact. Parents are so broke. This economic crunch didn't spare anyone. And trust me, the government should do something, or else people are going to have the children at home for a long time.
Report compiled by Ismail Kasoha and Disan Mutiaba for the news.